Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how the static keyword modifier works in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright guys and gals, I'm going to be explaining the static keyword modifier. This is a keyword modifier that can be applied to a variable, a method, or even classes, but that's a separate video. So anything that is static is also known as a static member, and a good way of thinking about this is that the class that contains that static member now owns that member, whether it's a variable or a method. So anything that the class owns is shared by all instances of that class, meaning if we create objects from this class, they all have to share this one variable or method. There is only one copy. So let me explain this with an example. I have a class called friend, and we're going to be constructing some friend objects. So I have the constructor and one parameter set up where we have to send in a name. So let's create a static variable called number of friends. So all instances of the friend class have to share this one variable. So we use the static keyword modifier, then the data type of the variable, and let's say this is an integer, and this will be called number of friends. And if we were to display this, system.out.println, now this is owned by the class itself, so we do not need to create a friend object. We can just type in the name of the class, friend, followed by what we're trying to access, number of friends. And I'm using Eclipse. You can see here that I have this little red S next to this variable. That shows that this is a static variable, and if we were to print the number of friends that we have, it's unfortunately zero. So let's create some friends. So let's create one friend object. So friend, let's call him friend1 for the instance name, equals new friend, and assign a friend name of maybe SpongeBob, because that's the first thing I thought of. And then within the constructor, let's increment the amount of friends that we have. So after everything is done, we'll add 1 to the number of friends that we have. So we now have 1 friend. Now let's create another friend. The name of this instance will be friend2, and we'll pass in a name of Patrick. And now the number of friends that we have is 2. So both friend1 and friend2 are sharing the same number of friends variable, because there is only a single copy, and the class itself owns the static member. And if we were to create another friend, guess what's going to happen? Friend3, the name this time will be Squidward. And we now have 3 friends. Now, it's entirely possible to access a static variable using an object instance name itself. So let's replace friend with friend1. So it is possible to access this static variable using the named instance of an object from this class, but it's not recommended, and you can see here that there's a warning. The static field friend.numberofFriends should be accessed in a static way. So it is best practice to type in the name of the class that owns the static member, followed by the static member that you're trying to access. So this will display the number of friends that we have, and since there is only one copy, all of these instances of the friend class are forced to share this static member. So what do you think would happen if we removed the static modifier from this variable? Well, for one, we can no longer access this variable in a static way. So you can see that it says, cannot make a static reference to the non-static field friend.numberofFriends. So each of these friend objects now has their very own copy of the number of friends variable, and in order to display one of these copies of the number of friends variable, we would type in the name of the instance of this class, for example friend1, and their own number of friends is 1. Same thing goes for friend2, as well as friend3. So if we change this back to static, we can make a static reference to this static variable, and this will display the total amount of friends that we have created from this class, which is 3. And not only can you apply the static keyword modifier to a variable, but you can also apply it to a method as well. So let's create a static method that returns the amount of friends that we have within a message. So let's use the static keyword modifier, and then the return type is void, and the name will be display friends. And within this method, we'll just have a println statement. So system.out.println, you have plus number of friends plus friends within a string. So we no longer need this line. Now the preferred way of calling this method is by the class name and not the name of one of its instances. So if we want to call this method, this static method of the friend class, we're going to type the name of the friend class and not one of these instances, dot, and then the method that we want to call. And you can see that we have a static method called displayFriends. And when we call this method, it's going to display our message. You have three friends. And then if we created another friend, for example, like Sandy, and this will be friend four, and we call this method, we now have four friends. Now, a good example of a static method is the round method of the math class. So we type in the name of the math class. This is an unrelated example, by the way, dot round. And you can see that this is a static method. And let's take a look at the math class. So let's look for round. Okay, here is one copy of this method. And you can see that it's a static method. So we type in the name of the math class. Like, it wouldn't make sense to create a math object like math equals new math, right? It's much more simple just to type the name of the class and then use the function that you want, dot round, for example. So that's the benefit of static modifiers. It creates a single copy of a member, a variable, a method, or even an inner class too. And all instances of that class have to share that one static member. And if you need to access that static member, you use the name of the class itself. So that's the basics of the static keyword modifier. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how to use the static modifier in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.